Several months ago, a Cabal vessel bearing the name Glycon disappeared near the reef. This ship matches its description and heading. So far, our hails have gone unanswered, and the distress signal continues to loop. You're clear for live fire engagements. Board it, and find our missing guardian. Executing trace. Stand by. I've sourced a distortion. There's an open patch into the ship's computer. Perhaps courtesy of our lost friend. Those spores are harmonizing with the nearby concentration of darkness. There's no light here. The Glycon navigation system marks their destination as an anomaly left in the wake of Mars's disappearance. The only life sign aboard. I see at least one other. It may be our missing friend. It may not. I found a journal of Kallus' scribe, Palmsot. Translation as follows. Today, Kallus graced the Glycon with his presence and gazed upon the anomaly. His counselors prepared the exhibition chamber with gold from the Castellum. They are confident the crown is ready. The End will lay eyes upon him and weep at his magnificence. Passageways no longer connect as they should. Thank you. They relent. We must not. Forward. Guardian, I've pieced together another of Armsart's records. It reads, Tragedy of Silence. He tore the wilting failures apart himself. The connection is strong, but the darkness does not speak through them. An ocean without wind. Even the Lightbearer could not coax it to awaken. Hangar systems are intact. Why didn't they try to run? Armsarth kept notes on experiments as well. It seems that Scorn, exposed to the anomaly, all suffered contiguous neuron death. It consumed their minds. All but one who spoke with many dead voices. This survivor would become the centerpiece of their studies. Put this decrepit creature to rest. Guardian, this anomaly left in Mars's wake. I've seen it and others like it. Too many scorn for an active Guardian. In place of each world the darkness stole. At the edge of our heliopause. Kallus meant to commune with the darkness.